Pipe racks are structures that carry pipes connecting process units and equipment. Additionally, pipe racks also carry electrical and instrument cables and the necessary supports for them. At the same time, air coolers can also be installed on pipe racks. Pipe racks are generally made of steel but also can be made of concrete or a combination of concrete and steel structures. Proper design of piping within pipe racks is crucial for ensuring operational efficiency, safety, and regulatory compliance. Because of the close relation with the pipe rack structure, the pipe rack design must be considered together with the piping design. To design a pipe rack, we should have the PNID, flow diagram, plot plan, layout specification, client specification, construction material of the rack, fire protection requirement, and equipment details to be located around the pipe rack. Pipe rack design starts from the designation of the width, bent spacing, and elevations. Determining all of these, we should prepare a line routing diagram. Please see an example of a line routing diagram. A line routing diagram shows us a preliminary piping routing between the equipment of the plant. The cross-section of the diagram should include all the pipeline's cross-sections including line size, insulation, and line number. Line-specific information will help us to group the lines for process or fluid content and also help us to identify the width of the pipe rack. In a large plant, lining up all the piping lines side by side would lead us to design a very wide pipe rack. However, this is neither financially nor technically correct. Therefore, we should group the pipes according to their systems. This grouping is generally done in the oil and gas industry as process and utility lines. Process lines are positioned at a lower elevation, while utility lines are located at an upper elevation. Top level of the pipe rack is generally reserved for electrical and instrumentation cable trays. At an early stage of the process plant design, it is suggested to keep 10% or 20% space for the possible growth of piping lines during the engineering phase of the project. Also, at the end of the project, you may need to keep distance on pipe rack width for future extensions. All these are to be considered for the width designations of the pipe racks. Once the width of the pipe rack is decided, future growth should be carefully considered in terms of civil and structural requirements and cost impact. For example, the width would be 2 levels with 10 meters wide or 3 levels with 6 meters spacing. A line spacing chart is to be prepared, because it will be required for the additional line during future growth. See the figure of a typical pipe rack. There is a walkway on the top level. The walkway can be considered for cable pulling during construction, but also the walkway can be used for possible maintenance requirements. Moreover, the aforementioned walkway can serve as an accessible path for the passage through the pipe racks during the operation. An accessway spacing is also considered under the rack because of the serviceability of the equipment located on the ground elevation. Pipe spacing is one of the most important items to be considered if you are designing a pipe rack. Before deciding on the pipe rack column distance, the average line size is to be designated, and then, support spacing calculation is to be done as per the average size of the pipe. You can watch the previous video about the support spacing calculation. The calculated support spacing will be used as guidance for choosing pipe rack column distance. For this, you should also consult with civil and structural engineers. Generally, 2 inches is the smallest size that is being used for pipe racks to avoid intermediate supports. If the lines consist of flanges inside the rack, they should be located as staggered. This will provide minimum line distance. The minimum height of the pipe rack is to be decided according to the vehicle, forklift or truck, passing from the road under the pipe rack. Generally, the minimum height is 3,600 mm. Determining the exit level above and below, considering the 45-degree turn height of the largest diameter and the 90-degree turn height of the average line size. The highest elevation should be preferred. The exit level above and below the rack can be 800 mm to 1,200 mm. The use of flat turns should be avoided as they cannot serve to change the sequence of lines. Instead, use the elevation difference method for the pipe rack turns. From the isometric view, it is evident that the change in sequence is practical. If two secondary pipe racks are connected to a main pipe rack, they should be staggered or located east of one bay because of the challenges of the branch connection design. Any equipment can be located over the pipe racks. Pipe racks are generally fireproofed until the lower elevation, but if there is equipment located over the pipe rack, the fireproofing must be extended until the equipment supports. A piping designer should consider the thickness of fireproofing for piping design to prevent possible clashes. During pipe rack design, future expansion should also be considered. Vertical risers should be kept away from the columns for horizontal expansions. Also, any piping line, cable tray, or support cannot be located over the pipe rack column due to the future vertical expansion. The future expansion is not only for a pipe rack but also for an air cooler or heat exchanger. As we come to the end of this video on pipe rack design for piping, it's important to understand the delicate balance between structural integrity and efficient piping layout. By carefully considering factors such as load distribution, support spacing, and material selection, we can create safe and cost-effective piping systems. It's important to remember that a well-designed pipe rack not only supports the piping but also facilitates maintenance, expansion, and overall operational efficiency. Stay tuned for more insights into piping stress and design engineering, as we continue to explore the fascinating world of piping systems. Thank you for watching, and until next time, keep innovating and engineering with excellence.